गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, विश यू ऑल द बेस्ट। टुडे वी शैल डिस्कस चैप्टर नंबर 4 स्टैंडर्ड 4 चैप्टर 4 ग्रामर सेक्शन इंग्लिश काइंड्स ऑफ एडजेक्टिव काइंड्स ऑफ एडजेक्टिव। सो स्टूडेंट्स, बिफोर वी एंटर इनटू द चैप्टर लेट मी टेल यू अबाउट व्हाट इज एन एडजेक्टिव। व्हाट इज एन एडजेक्टिव? एडजेक्टिव रेफर्स टू the character, quality, character and quality character of thing, man, anything etc and etc. So there is four main kinds of adjectives. There are four main kinds of adjectives. Let us discuss one by one. First comes proper adjective. Nothing has been described in your textbook, so let me tell you more about the adjective. Number one, proper adjective. So what is a proper adjective? Adjective derives from a proper noun. Adjective derives from a proper noun is called proper adjective. For example, Indian, Chinese, Bengali, English, Punjabi, anything. And these are called proper adjectives. Suppose if I say Chinese food, so here from the China is the name of a country and country China is the name of a noun, it is a proper noun. So Chinese is the example of proper adjective. Then number two, descriptive adjective. What is that? Once again, descriptive adjective. A word that describes a noun. A word that describes a noun. For example, Rohan is a good boy. Rohan is a good boy. So here you see Rohan is the noun and good is the adjective. And the word good describes what kind of boy, what type of boy Rohan is, or the noun is. So this is an example of descriptive adjective. Then number three, quantitative adjective. What is that? Quantitative adjective. It describes exact amount of a noun. Exact amount of a noun. This is called quantitative adjective. So for example, much, little, few, some, any, n of these are the examples of quantitative adjectives. Then come number 4, numeral adjective. What is numeral adjective? Quantity. Many, there are two types of numeral adjective, ordinal and cardinal. First, second, third is ordinal, then cardinal 1, 2, 3, 4. These are the examples of numeral adjective. Okay. Then let us discuss the use of some adjectives. In which places the different adjectives can be used? Different adjectives are used in different places. There are certain rules and regulations. So, abiding by the rules and regulations, we use the different adjectives as well. Let us discuss one by one. You see, some, any, no, much, many, a little, a few. Where they can be used. There are certain places we can use them. You see, we use some in affirmative sentence. What is an affirmative sentence? An affirmative sentence, there will be a subject, a verb, an object. We can call it an affirmative sentence. What is affirmative sentence? That is simple sentence. What is affirmative sentence? That is simple sentence. In these sentences, we use some. We use some in the affirmative sentences. We use any in question and negative sentence. If the question, if the sentence is in question form, is in double short form, in question form, then we can use any. And second thing is that if the sentence is in negative form, if the sentence is in negative form, in that place we can also put any. We can write any with the negative sentences. Then we use no in place of not any. If there is not any, then we should omit not any, then write no in order to make it a what is that? Adjective, proper adjective. We use must and any with uncountable nouns. We use much and elative with uncountable nouns. So students, what is uncountable noun? A noun that can't be counted. A noun that cannot be counted is called uncountable noun. So with uncountable noun we use much and a little. Then we use many and a few with countable plural noun. First thing, the noun should be counted. The noun should be counted and they should be plural in form. They should be plural form. Suppose if I say apple. Apple is a fruit. You can easily count it. So in that place, we use many or a few. So let me discuss bit by bit. It will be better for you if I make out the exercises. If I saw the exercises, you can understand them better about the adjectives. Sure, student, let us come and discuss its exercises as well. Okay?
Just I told you, if you go through the exercises, you can understand it in a better way. So, here the first exercise, what has this man in his suitcase put in some, any or more? You see the figure? The figure is in your book. And having seen the figure, you have to put some, any or no. What has this man in his suitcase? He has dash clothes. He has some clothes. He has dash camera. I told you, just now I told you, if the sentence is in interrogative form or in question form, you can use any. So you see, at the last part of the sentence there is question mark and beginning of the sentence there is helping verb. So it is an interrogative sentence. In an interrogative sentence we have to apply any. So has he any camera? Then he has dash cameras. He has dash cameras. So if you see the plural nouns, plural countable nouns, we should use some. So camera, you can easily count it. It is a countable plural noun. So we have to write some. He has some cameras, but he has no watches. He does not have any watches. He has dash watches. He has no watches. He has not dash videos. You see, this sentence is in negative form. This sentence is in negative form. So we can use any. If the sentence is in negative form, we use any. So he has not any videos. He has dash money. He has some money. Has he dash perfume or cigarettes? It is a question word sentence. So we should write any. He has he any perfume or cigarettes? He has some perfume. He has some perfume. He has dash perfume. He has some perfume. But he has dash cigarettes. He has no cigarettes. Then question number 2. This man is not happy with this hotel room. You can see in your textbook the figure is there. So you can understand it better if you see better. You can understand it better if you see the figure as well. So having seen the figure, you will have to put there is or there are. How? No. Using make sentences using there is or there and no. Number one has been given for you. There is no shop here. That means that man is not satisfied with this hotel room. So he has expressed his disgusting. He has expressed his view that I am not satisfied. Although I have booked the ticket, I have purchased the room, I have booked the ticket, I am staying inside the room, but I am not satisfied with the instruments provided in the room. So there is no shop here. Number two, there are no towels here. So how can he bath? In order to have a bath, we need a towel. So there is no towel. There is no towels here. There is hot water in the room. The water of the room is very hot. Is it possible on his part to adjust in such a hot water, to bath in such a hot water, to take such hot water? So he is not satisfied with this hot water. There is no toilet paper here. So toilet paper is required. Toilet paper is most necessary. And there is no toilet paper. There are no hangers in the wardrobe. Why can he hang his dresses, hang his clothes? There is no hanger. Then, now, number three, now write each sentence using any. So students, I have told you in which places you can use any. Number one, you can use any in negative sentences. In negative sentences, we can use any. Then, in interrogative sentence, in question form, if the sentence is in question form, we can use any. So, let us write. Make sentences first. Interrogative, then negative. First, interrogative, then negative. So before that, we should write the sentences. Also, write down just one before. I told you. The next sentence, next question, number three, make these sentences interrogative and negative. Here is a sentence for you. At first, you have to bring the sentence, you have to convert the sentence into interrogative form. Then the same sentence should be converted into negative forms. They asked some questions. The sentence is, they asked some questions. Here is the first sentence for you. They asked some questions. First, we will have to convert it into interrogative. Then, we will have to convert it into negative form. So, answer is, did they ask any question? Question mark at the end of the sentence. Because it is an interrogative sentence. Did they ask any question? Number B. They did not ask any questions. You see, question is in past form. If you want to convert a simple past sentence, then you have to take the help of did and not. Negative form, not. They did not ask any questions. Question number two. They gave you some money. They gave you some money. And if you want to bring it into interrogative one, then you have to convert it into interrogative form. Did he give you any money? Did he give you any money? Then B. he did not give you any money. He did not give you any money. Then question number 3. Question number 3. They want no help. Sorry. She wants some more fruits. Fruit. She wants some more food. Fruit. Then interrogative. Does she want any more fruit? Interrogative. Then we will have to convert it into a negative one. She does not want any more fruit. Number 4. Anu wants some chocolates. Anu wants some chocolates. Interrogative. Does Anu want any chocolates? Does Anu want any chocolates? Then negative. Anu does not want any chocolate. Anu does not want any chocolate. Number 5. They know some people here. They know some people here. Interrogative sentence. What will be the answer? Do they know any people here? Do they know any people here? Number B. Negative. They don't know any people here. Number 6. The girls had some blue frocks. The girls had some blue frocks. Did the girls have any blue frocks? Interrogative. Negative. The girls did not have any blue frocks. Rewrite each sentence using not any. Rewrite each sentence using not any. I have no time today. I have no time today. Answer. I don't have any time today. I don't have any time today. He has no work to do. Second question. He has no work to do. He does not have any work to do. Number 3. They want no help from you. They want no help from you. They don't want any help from you. Then the question number 4. There is no sugar in the pot. There is not any sugar. There is not any sugar in the pot. The hen has laid no egg today. The hen has laid no egg today. Then there are no apples on that tree. Then question number 5, 6, 7 has been given you for homework. Then rewrite this sentence using no. I have not any bread to eat. I have not any bread to eat. You have to put no in the sentence. I have no bread to eat. Number 2. There was not any girl in the class. There was not any girl in the class. There was no girl in the class. We have to write no in place of not. There is not any letter for you today. There is no letter for you today. So we omitted not and put no in the sentence. Question number 4. There are not any chairs in the room. There are not any chairs in the room. There are no chairs in the room. Question number 5. She did not tell me anything. She did not tell me anything. Answer. She told me nothing. Anything was omitted. Nothing has been written. Number 6. We did not go anywhere. We did not go anywhere yesterday. We went nowhere yesterday. Number 7, there was not anybody in the class. There was not anybody in the class. There was nobody. We'll have to write any, we'll have to omit anybody, and in place of, in the place of anybody, we'll have to write nobody in the class. Then look at this table. How much? How many? Roses, bread, petrol, tickets, money, stamps. Do you want? So now write what questions they ask. Are this, if you go to this place, then what type of question you will have to ask? Suppose you go to the bank. You are in a bank. At a bank, what should you tell the bankers? How much money? What sort of question the banker will ask you? How much money do you want? How much money do you want? At a theater, how many tickets do you want? At a baker's, how much breads do you want? The baker will ask you, how much bread do you want? So, if you go to post office, then the post office employees will ask you, how much stamps do you want? And if you go to a flower shop, if you are at a flower shop, then they ask you, how many roses do you want? Question number 6, if you go to the filling station, petrol station, they will ask you, how much petrol do you want? Then, next question, fill in the blanks with a little or a few. Children, you see, in which place a little is used and in which place a few is used. Right now I told you, just now I told you, a little is used for uncountable nouns. A little is used for uncountable nouns. If the noun is uncountable, what is an uncountable noun? When we are unable to count the noun, it is called uncountable noun. In that place, we can use a little. And the countable nouns with plural forms. Countable nouns with plural forms. In that case, we use a few. I have dash pen in my head. I have dash pen in my head. I have a little pen in my head. I have, because pen is an uncountable noun. There are dash coins in my pocket. So coins, you can count it. So you write a few. Radha has dash money in her purse. Radha has a little money in her purse. Number 4. Please give me dash oranges. Oranges, you can count it. Oranges is the countable plural form. So we use a few. We use a few. Number 5. There is only dash water in the bottle. So water is a uncountable noun. So we use a little. There is only a little water in the bottle. There are only dash boys in the class. Boys, you can count it. It is a countable noun. So we use a few. Then she has a dash cheese and dash tomatoes. You see, cheese is an uncountable noun. So we wrote a little before cheese. A little has been written before cheese because cheese is an uncountable noun. Then and dash tomatoes. Tomatoes, you can count it, count them easily. So a few tomatoes. Then formation of comparative and superlative. Tall, tall, taller, tallest. Tall, taller, tallest. Then fine, finer, finest. Great, greater, greatest. Small, smaller, smallest. Brave, braver, bravest. Sweet, sweeter, sweetest. Positive, comparative or superlative. So children, you see how you turn the adjective into comparative form. If you write er, it is in most of the cases, in most of the cases, if you write er, small, smaller, it is comparative. Then if you write est, tallest, at the last part of the word, est is there, so it is superlative. Then bigger, big, bigger, biggest. Fat, fatter, fattest. Read, reader, readest. Red, redder, readest. Sad, sadder, saddest. Hot, hotter, hottest. Thin, thinner, thinnest. Dry, drier, driest. Easy, easier, easiest. Pretty, prettier, prettiest. Heavy, heavier, heaviest. Happy, happier, happiest. Difficult, more difficult, most difficult. Difficult, more difficult, most difficult. Obedient, more obedient, most obedient. Bad, worse, worst. Good, better, best. Little, less, least. Much or many, more, most. Old, older, oldest. So these are the positive, comparative and negative. Sorry, superlative. Positive, comparative and superlative. Then choose the correct adjective from each blank. Choose the correct adjective for each blank. Tall, taller, tallest. Tall, so you have to use tall, taller, tallest. Radha is a dash girl. Radha is a tall girl. Neha is not so dash as Radha. Neha is not so tall as Radha. Alka is as dash as Radha. Alka is as tall as Radha. Alpana is dash than Radha. You see, than is there. Than is there. Then, if you see than, then you have to make it comparative adjective. So, Alpana is taller than Radha. Alpana is the dash of the of all girls. So, you see, before dash, adjective, definite article, D is there. If you see, a definite article, D is there, then there will be superlative degree of, superlative form of the adjective. Alpana is the tallest of all girls. Fill in the blanks with A, an, as, so, the, then. We live in an dash old house. We live in dash old house. We live in an old house. They live in dash big house. They live in dash big house. They live in a big house. Our house is not dash big as theirs. Our house is not as big as theirs. Their house is bigger dash our house. Their house is bigger than our house. That is dash biggest house in our lane. That is the biggest house in our lane. So the will be answer. It is dash big as a palace. It is as big as a palace or so big as a palace. Anything can write. Rewrite this sentence with not. Anu is wiser than Sonu. Anu is wiser than Sonu. In this case, we will have to write not. In this sentence, we have to write not. Sonu is not so wise as Anu. Sonu is not so wise as Anu. Then, nights are colder than days. Nights are colder than days. Nights are colder than days. Days are not so cold as nights. Days are not so cold as night. Number 3. Honey is sweeter than sugar. Honey is sweeter than sugar. So the answer is sugar is not so sweet as honey. Sugar is not so sweet as honey. Number 4. The sun is hotter than the moon. The sun is hotter than the moon. Then the answer is the moon is not so hot as the sun. The moon is not so hot as the sun. Number 5. Maths is more difficult than English. Math is more difficult than English. English is not so difficult as math. Peacocks, number 6. Peacocks are more beautiful than the peahens. Answer. Peahens are not so beautiful as peacocks. Peahens are not so beautiful as peacocks. Then, complete each sentence. Complete the second sentence in each pair using a superlative. Using a superlative. This building is very old. This building is very old. So, we have to turn it into superlative form. This is the oldest building. This is the oldest building in our town. It was a very cold day. It was, the answer is, it was the coldest day of the year. Anu is a very tall girl. Anu is the tallest girl in our class. The rose is a very loveliest of all flowers. So students, this is the end of the chapter. This is the end of the chapter. The kinds of adjectives, standard 4. If you have any problem, you can contact us. You can ask us, you can clarify yourselves in our Zoom classes. It is being conducted in every day 7 p.m. 7 p.m. in the evening. Every day it is being conducted. And you can understand. If you have any doubt, you can ask us question. So students, this is the end of the class. And give us like, comment or share if you are satisfied with our teachings, if you are satisfied with us. So, that is the end of the class. Thank you.